Welcome to World Tech Update. I'm Martin Williams and we're in Tokyo this week. And we start off with news of the passage of the controversial anti-counterfeiting trade agreement by the European Parliament in Strasbourg.
The bill seeks to enforce intellectual property rights and combat online piracy and illegal software, and has been controversial due to the secrecy imposed by the US during its negotiation. The full text was only published 10 days ago and includes a contentious paragraph that allows countries to introduce the so-called three strikes rule. This would allow governments to cut internet users off if they download copyrighted material.
That is adopted.
The bill passed by 331 to 294 votes, with 11 members abstaining. The relatively high vote against represents the MEPs who were angry at being kept in the dark for much of the negotiating period. The vote means that, in principle, the final legal text can now be agreed by the Commission at a meeting in Sydney from November 30th to December 3rd.
Now to New York, where on Tuesday Acer unveiled new tablet computers. The largest has a 10-inch screen and runs Google's Android operating system.
Acer also plans an Android tablet with a 7-inch screen and showed off this Android phone. It has a 5-inch screen and Acer's calling it a mini tablet. The company will launch the products early next year when Android 3.0 is available. Acer isn't sticking solely to Android, it also plans to release a Windows-based tablet. We asked Acer's CEO about mobile operating system competition.
If you think about 1 billion mobile devices in 3 years from now, in my opinion, there will be enough space for much more than one or two operating systems. So I think Microsoft, first of all, if I look at Windows, Phone 7, you start to see a lot of improvement. Very good user interface. They start to leverage a lot of assets that they have, like Windows Live and Xbox and so on. I'm confident that Microsoft will come back with a very good offer on Windows Mobile. I think Windows Mobile 7 is already much better than before.
Acer also showed the Iconia, a laptop-style PC with two 14-inch touchscreens. The top screen acts as the main display, and the lower screen is the input or navigation interface. It's due out in Europe in January.
Back here to Japan, and Panasonic has recently refreshed its Eco House that highlights environmentally friendly lifestyles using current and soon-to-launch products.
Panasonic says it's now possible to live an emission-free lifestyle using the technology in the house. New is this storage battery that collects power generated during the day by solar panels on the roof. Electricity is stored in lithium-ion batteries in the unit and used when needed. The battery storage is linked in with lighting and heating throughout the house and extends as far as the garage, where it can be used to charge an electric car. This is a new EV charging system developed by Panasonic that will soon go on sale, and it's being used with an upcoming Toyota hybrid car. Also new is a climate control system that synchronizes the air conditioner with a floor heater, so energy is most efficiently used to heat the house.
Now to computer security, and on Monday the European Union announced plans to better counter cyber threats.
We plan to establish an EU cyber centre under Europol and establish a network of computer emergency response teams in all member states as well in the EU institutions in order to better respond to future cyber attacks.
The cybercrime centre and a European information sharing and alert system will be established by 2013, with the computer emergency response teams coming in 2012. Meanwhile, over the last weekend, the US and Europe said they'd set up a working group on cybersecurity that will focus on potential threats to the regular consumer and industry. It'll report back in a year. And NATO adopted at its Lisbon summit the Strategic Concept Charter. The document includes plans to develop new capabilities to combat cyber attacks on military networks. The document stopped short of active cyber defense. That would have included preemptive cyber strikes favored by the Pentagon. Now some news in brief, and a California jury awarded Oracle $1.3 billion in damages against SAP. The German software maker admitted that its now closed Tomorrow Now subsidiary illegally downloaded massive amounts of software and support materials from an Oracle website. The verdict followed a 3-week trial that captivated Silicon Valley, and the damages are much higher than the $40 million SAP had been arguing it should pay. WikiLeaks said on Twitter that it's planning to release a load of information 7 times bigger than the Iraq war logs. The website didn't say what the new release of information will be about or when it will be available. And further delays for the first Robonaut, scheduled to be launched on space shuttle mission STS-133. NASA has set a launch no earlier than December 17th. It's been delayed for more tests and analysis after cracks were found on 2 aluminium brackets on the shuttle's external fuel tank.
You know, we would have liked to have found the most probable cause by now, and things would be a lot more straightforward. This is turning out to be a little more complicated from an analysis standpoint, and it doesn't lend itself to a very easy answer.
And finally this week, Panasonic's Evolticon robot has done it again. On Monday, it arrived in Kyoto after a 500-kilometer long journey from here in Tokyo.
It took the old Tokaido Road that was once the main thoroughfare between Tokyo and Kyoto, stopping daily at each of the 53 stations or rest points along the road. The little robot, developed to showcase Panasonic's batteries, spent 24 hours traveling around the Le Mans circuit last year on just 2 batteries. In 2008, it climbed a 530-meter rope to the top of the Grand Canyon. Evolta's designer saw the 500-kilometer trip as the robot's biggest challenge yet.
Now, the first one took only 6 hours, and the second one took 24 hours, and this time it's, you know, a couple months. It's, you know, much, much longer. That means, you know, much, much harder. Mm-hmm. And also, situation of the, I mean, the surface of the road is always changing, and also weather is changing.
This time, Evolticon ran on 12 of Panasonic's new rechargeable nickel metal hydride AA batteries.
And that's it for this week's World Tech Update. I'm Martin Williams, and on behalf of everybody at IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.